So by taking away the 12 inches, what we have now is we have a lot longer tube for cutting the chooridar out from. When laying this out, you want the corners to lay straight on where the crutch seam is going to come, and you want as little seam in, obviously, in the leg as possible. And basically that's all there is. What we're going to do is cut the one leg and then transfer it over and cut the other leg. The way to go about cutting this is measure down from the crotch, which is here, and you want approximately 16 inches for the crotch. Measure for your hip. So if you want a hip measurement of, on this one, we're going to do a hip measurement of quite a large, quite a wide one, because she's expecting, so we need to have it wide, which is going to be 52 inches. So half of 52 is 26, half of 26 is 13. I'll do this about 15 inches. 15 inches curved in to angled out approximately 2 inches, and then this is the thigh area, and going down is the leg area. Now if you look at this type of chooridar, you've got a seaming, a double seaming, which comes a lot lower than what you would ordinarily get in a chooridar of cutting in the way I generally teach. So I prefer to teach the other way. I prefer to do my chooridar the other way, but it's everybody's own personal preference on how they want the chooridar cutting. This is the calf measurement around here, and we're going to elasticate this so that there are some gathers. Generally, what happens with the chooridar is the gathers tend to fall. So I've just roughly marked this, and I'm going to, once I've cut into this, I'm going to take this and lay it out, and then put my second part on. You alternate this, going to the other side, and you actually just cut exactly the same, laying the one on top of the other. Now what we're going to be doing with this is we require a length of approximately 39. This is going to be way too long, so leave a turning allowance, and that's the length that we require. So approximately from here to, this is the area from the crotch to the mid-calf area, and we want all this actually elasticating. So I'll put a couple of notches there, just to so that I know where I'm going to elasticate this from. And the rest is just basic common sense. You do the seaming around the crotch area, turn the hem over, elasticate on the top, and basically just do the inside leg seam. And voila, that is chooridar.